Good morning. Welcome to Morning Devotions. I'm Pastor Corby, and I'm sitting in Scottsdale, Arizona at my home, my childhood home, with my mother in the other room drinking tea. What a lovely morning. What a beautiful time to be with family. Today's Tuesday, December 21st, and we're in Proverbs 28, 27 through 28. Those who give to the poor will lack nothing, but those who close their eyes to them receive many curses. When the wicked come to power, rise to power, people go into hiding. But when the wicked perish, the righteous thrive. When the wicked perish, the righteous thrive. Oh, isn't that a lovely thought? I don't know what you think about the word wicked or what images that brings to you in your life about wickedness, behaving wicked and being truly wicked. I don't think any of us really want the wicked to thrive, do we? I want you to imagine with me today, driving by panhandlers on the street or walking by them outside of the stores or seeing them sitting at a bus stop with meager worldly possessions to maybe keep them a little warm, maybe a bedroll to keep them off the dewy grass or the hard concrete or ground. Imagine panhandlers on the street and outside the stores, especially this time of year. It seems that each year there are more homeless, more people in need, more people living on the streets and on the street corners or outside of a store asking for help. What does seeing them feel like to you? Does that anger rise in you and you think, oh, just get a job? Or does compassion take over and you wonder how they got into that position? And maybe you could just sit and have a warm cup of cocoa or coffee or tea or something with them and hear their story. Everyone has a story. And sometimes it definitely goes from riches to rags. As an activity, I know it can be overwhelming at times, especially during the holidays, to see so many people in need in your neighborhood, maybe where you work, at the schools that go to school with your children. Have a family meeting. This is a good time to do that. Have a family meeting and talk about people in need. Look around your neighborhood, even in your church. Set aside some funding in your family to help people in need when you see a need. You can keep some money in your car tucked away somewhere safe or in your purse or wallet. Maybe a gift card or two. Maybe some warm socks and sweatshirts, something like that, gloves, especially during this time. Living in Arizona, you just don't think it's cold here, but once you live here and acclimate, it's cold enough that you need some warm clothing. And you need something to keep you from the concrete when you sleep or from the grass or dirt where they end up sleeping. So have a card with you from an organization in your community that can be helpful, that they can use. As an action, if you can, bring this up to your church or to the business that you work for and ask them if they have anything in their means to help, especially during this time of year, to help, not grudgingly or not feeling obligated to do it, but with joy, knowing that you will bring warmth to somebody's heart, knowing that God has directed your path to cross with that person in need. And I know we talk about this a lot during the holidays, during Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's, but these are needs that go all year long. So if you can, in your home, make out a little budget. How much can you spare on a monthly basis that you just tuck somewhere close to you that when you see the need, you can give? And it's not just giving money or a hot meal. It's giving of yourself. Sacrificial sometimes. Just like the mentor that we all have in Jesus Christ, who gave when he was here on earth and continues to give through us every day. God's blessings to you. Stay warm. And keep your eyes open. Today is the day.